I'm going to talk about the mysteries of self-realization with the quote from my book, Out-of-Body Journeys to Self-Realization, chapter 12, which is called The Plastic Flower versus the Real Flower. Letting God direct our course instead of the false self is like playing beautiful music as you become the instrument, God's instrument in the universal symphony, tuned to the divine sound current that flows from God. I looked upon what looked like a mighty river of light. The waters were not water, but composed entirely of a light radiance, substance that flows and yet seems still. A liquid light in vast waters. The sound, like pure ethereal flute, was in one long, continuous, never-ending note. In the world of being, pure soul without mind visits and eventually makes it its permanent home in the first heaven in the state called self-realization. And when I say first level of heaven, I'm not speaking of the five lower planes. The astral plane is the first psychic heavenly plane that appears to be heaven to those who have near-death experiences, experience angels, spiritual cities, fantastical sights, and sort of astral euphoria. It becomes brighter and more high in vibration the higher we go, but it is not a heaven of freedom. Above and beyond the astral plane is the causal plane, which has a white-orange light, where the Akashic records of past, present, and future are stored in a storehouse of multidimensional holograms that have records of our many past lives. The vibration can become so high that some feel they've reached a very high state of consciousness. This is Maya, illusion. Then, the next higher plane beyond this is the mental plane. It's a heaven composed of even less matter and even more spirit, with a brighter, wider light and a subtle blue, a light that's blazing white. Just as the etheric plane just beyond it is sometimes so luminous and high vibrational, filled with heavenly wonders, that it's often mistaken for the ultimate heaven, but it is not. No, all of these supposed heavens are heavens or planes of reincarnation, where soul is still not free. Master Peter Zsak, Paul G. often spoke of these worlds as being composed of mist, matter, energy, space, and time. But the illusion of these worlds is so powerful and enchanting and just plain heavenly that most souls are fooled into believing they've found the ultimate heaven and even God itself. But the entity or entities in these different planes, for instance, there's a powerful creator entity in the mental plane, which can appear as a brilliant, bright light, or it can be experienced as a powerful man. It's very commonly mistaken for God, this Brahm, but it is the job of this Brahm to keep soul trapped, imprisoned in reincarnation, until the day comes that soul's desire for God is so strong that the powerful illusions of these psychic heavens or planes are broken like glass. And then the brilliance, or far greater brilliance of God, Hure, breaks through. Far beyond these psychic planes and beyond the dark void is the first pure, positive God world, a true heaven, the soul plane. Living here are the brothers of belief, whom after years of practice in Tusa travel, by which unwinding all their lower world's karma, free themselves from karma and reincarnation, and then know Jivan Mukti, or spiritual liberation. Continuing on, in the center of a vast light was Sat Nam, and Sat Nam sent impressions, quote, "You are like this river that streams of negative currents, negative thoughts, and material and psychic realities can flow through you, or the pure, unobstructed sound current and pure light. Rivers of light and sound can flow through you to the worlds below. The source of this light current is God, all sustaining. The soul in self-realization exists this way. Life awakens itself in your presence and is given new life by the presence of the self-realized." I then sense some kind of echo or reverberance in the stillness as it continued, quote, "Self-realization is not doing. Self-realization is being. You are self-realized when a traveler introduces you to your God self." As this awareness came, bagpipe mixed with flute-like sound flowed out with no end. Even in the midst of discord in the physical world, there is serenity. The negative power sends messengers to make you doubt yourself. We are better off ignoring such messages and instead place the awareness on God in this pure world. Then, in pure spirit, the heart dwells there. The currents of life, like a river, can lead us to flow in a certain direction. We need to flow with the Divine Master. The rivers of light and sound, or pure spirit stream. The astral body is commonly mistaken for soul. It glows like stars, and people will say that my soul was healed or trapped, but really what they're talking about is the astral body. It is the emotional body that corresponds with the astral plane, which is the emotional plane. Just like the mental body is a body for perceptions of the mind power, and as well as the other bodies, but it is actually the astral body, and it is often very commonly mistaken for soul. Instead, our true self, soul, is a spark of God. It is only pure spirit, an essence of spirit that is beyond time and space, and soul is eternal. It knows without mind. When we enter the soul plane, or first heaven of self-realization beyond all these lower worlds, we leave the mind behind and perceive only as pure spirit, all-knowing, all-seeing, and being. The soul plane has no messed matter, energy, space, and time. And in fact, in the lower worlds, it's a powerful illusion of being beyond time and space, but it is not. Instead, the soul plane is only pure spirit, and only spirit, magnificent light and sound. The lower worlds, below the soul plane or second grand division, have duality, light and dark, good and evil. But in the soul plane, it contains none of these opposites. There is no good or evil. There is only pure spirit, only pure whiteness, and the single note, melody of a flute, sound current that flows over a vast landscape of pure whiteness. And I'll briefly add that according to Shunyamuti, in his article called The Meaning of Self-Realization, he shares this quote, quote, "The more intelligent we become in terms of being able to manipulate symbolic forms, the more alienated we become from the real that lies beyond the realm of symbols. I'm not trying to imply that Shugnamurti is making contact with this soul plane of self-realization. Instead, rather, I'm just quoting his words to clarify the sharp contrast that abstract language and direct experience of heaven are entirely different. One is assumption, and the other is real, or rather, realization. Throughout history, the Vardhan masters have practiced divine methods and techniques to dwell far beyond the lower worlds in the pure positive God worlds. And so, we can say that self-realization is a matter of surrender of the power of symbolic manipulation, investigation, and articulation to the higher power of presence. We mistakenly substitute abstract thought forms in place of the pure heaven realities in the world of being. There are some which mistake the astral euphorias and fantastical astral experiences and extravaganzas for the pure positive God worlds. The psychic and spiritually do not meet. There are some who say higher realms are lofty, impractical, or unreal fictions. This view neglects to see there are thousands upon thousands of individuals who have had these experiences of heavenly divine realities to mostly a material reality. Instead, one can walk with their feet on earth and consciousness in heaven to awakening and having contact with the divine power greater than the human self through true experiencing contact with the divine. From my experience in out-of-body travel for many years, I've come to feel that the true spiritual travelers are the only guides capable of taking soul to the pure, positive God worlds by teaching the individual to go beyond books, meditation, and prayer, which only leads to the astral or mental planes, and instead learn soul or tusa travel to this world of being. There was a pure serenity about Sat Nam, and on all levels of heaven or lower bodies below, I sensed discord or tension, and it melted away. I had awakened that morning feeling tension, recalling sadness from life. Upon focusing on this pure world, this tension melted away like water with the shift of attention. The soft light was very bright, and the radiance of its presence was even brighter. Then from Sat Nam, the following, quote, "There are false gurus who will tell their students they have reached this self-realization state to rub their egos and yet not free their souls." This reminded me of when I followed one who claimed to be a master but was not. He was a student, and this is like the saying that Petter Zass sometimes said, that the teacher can only bring one to the heaven where he resides. It is like astral euphoria or empty titles, not the same thing. It is like receiving a plastic flower. The life force does not flow through it. It is an ornament instead of a state of being. This reminds me of how the astral currents can feel so miraculous as to easily be mistaken for the pure, positive God world currents. There was a vast love that emanated from Sat Nam, and I heard the expression, quote, fiance, And the funniest analogy came that self-realization can be likened in a sense like when one is in a state of being a fiancé and just about to soon come into marriage as a part, sort of analogy for marriage to God. Self-realization is like the transitioning point of setting into motion the eternal commitment as though a marriage to Hyre, or God, to become a conscious co-worker with God throughout eternity. True self-realization and true God-realization is not empty words, is not an empty title, nor is it marked by a distinguished beard, a robe, or sharp suit. It is not marked by large, fancy, impressive buildings, nor is it marked by cheering crowds. It is not marked by sagely looks with distinguished gray hair, or handsome, mature face, and worldly wisdom, nor even the ability to move out of body to visit students and visit the highly celestial and euphoric experiences abundant in the countless levels of the astral plane. The plastic flower looks impressive, but it is not a real flower. Only a simulation mistaken for the real thing. A simulation mistaken for the real flower. Ultimately, we have a choice between the illusion of self-realization in the lower worlds and the living reality of true self-realization that exists in out-of-body tusa, soul projection, making direct contact with the God power in the soul plane. The soul plane is not the end-all be-all. Some souls come here and they go no further. But beyond the soul plane, as we go deeper and deeper into the pure, positive God worlds, like the Alakalok plane, which is even more luminous with heavenly wind-like sound current. Paul G and all the Bardon Masters have experienced planes far lighter and higher in vibration. The Alakalok is even wider brilliancy, and the Hukkakat Lok, the sheer brilliance of the light is so startlingly incredible and so pure and ethereal. They are far beyond mind and human consciousness. The mind is left in the lower planes or worlds below. Far beyond the soul plane, deep into the God worlds, is the Anami Lok, which brings early stages of what we call God realization. God realization is simply moving as pure soul and establishing oneself permanently in the ocean of love and mercy, the ocean of God, and being fully conscious, dwelling with God in heaven while our feet are on earth, and to rise far beyond it and make direct contact with the light and sound, the omniscience, omnipotence, and omnipresence of the God power in the ocean of love and mercy. The Margatma, the Ancient One. It is the Margatma, the living Bardon Master. I say ancient because there is and has always been a living Bardon Master in times throughout history. In ancient China, in ancient Egypt, in ancient Atlantis, in Rome, in ancient Greece, the Middle Ages, and many cultures and ages throughout the world. The masses cannot find him, only souls that have a far greater desire and love for God and freedom will have the power to recognize him and free themselves on the returning wave home to God. Again, self-realization is not being a temporary visitor who temporarily visits the soul plane for a day or visits here and there. Visiting the soul plane does not mean we are self-realized. Self-realization is consciously making contact in full consciousness in the luminous, light and sound-filled soul plane. Day by day, moment by moment, as one dwells and lives as one's permanent or eternal home. As said before, when we reach the soul plane, we leave the mind behind in the lower worlds and experience pure seeingness, knowingness, and beingness. Pure spirit, or the pure spirit self that is all-seeing, all-knowing, and aware. In order to reach self-realization, the Living Vardhan Master helps soul unwind and resolve all of our past life karma. Each soul reincarnates over and over again and goes through many lives, usually far longer than is commonly known among the masses. Vardhankara is called the most direct path to God because our karma and everything can be worked out in one lifetime. This ancient wisdom or knowledge can be seen when we visit the Akashic records or the soul records, where we can look at our many past lives. Also, at self-realization, we have this profound breakthrough where the Chela has resolved all of his lower world karma and reached this state we call Jivan Mukti, meaning spiritual freedom. As the Margatma, the Living Vardhan Master pulls souls by their own merits and efforts beyond mest, matter, energy, space, and time. Higher states of consciousness must be earned by becoming disciplined in the ancient methods of this ancient one. Deeper into the pure realms, soul will eventually make an eternal commitment, a fantastic engagement, the eternal loyalty and devotion to the great Hure, God. And once we find this state, we dwell with Hure, God. And with God, loneliness does not exist. Then, at this moment, in the Tusa, soul flight experience, I see the spirit essence of a flower glowing with light, devoid of matter, but seemingly entirely light and sound, and heard the impressions, quote, accept only the real flower. May the blessings be.